This is Richard Wolff from Democracy at Work, responding to another Ask Prof Wolff question from our Patreon community. This one comes from Andre Katz and picks up on something we say fairly often on our platforms here at Democracy at Work. And that is that the way to look at the Soviet Union, the People's Republic of China, North Korea, Vietnam, Cuba, and so on, are that these are experiments. They are efforts to go beyond capitalism to a system that somehow is better. It's called socialism, at least that's what they've called it so far, a name given to these different experiments. But that's how they should be looked. And the reason we suggest that is because we are aware of how the transition from feudalism to capitalism a few centuries ago happened. And it happened that way. In other words, within the old feudal system of lords and serfs, efforts were made to do better, to go beyond feudalism, to end the relationship of lord and serf. And eventually those experiments, which at first often failed, they just fell in upon themselves. They couldn't sustain what they were trying to do. They barely understood. They did a lot of trial and error. But eventually they learned from their errors and their trials, and they figured out how to make the system work and last. And that empowered them then to make the whole transition that was symbolized and signaled by the American Revolution, which didn't replace King George III with another king, but wanted nothing to do with feudalism, and the French Revolution and so on, which did the same. So the question Andre Katz asks us is, he wants information to kind of support this argument we've been making. What were the actualities of the transition from feudalism to capitalism? Where do you go to learn the details so you can add some flesh to the skeleton argument we make that it's the right way to look at what has been going on over the last 100 years in terms of getting beyond capitalism? So I've put together some on the assumption that many of you might be interested. One of the great early classics about this question was by a French historian named Henri, the French word for Henry, Pirenne, P-I-R-E-N-N-E, who wrote a book about medieval cities. Why cities? Because that's where capitalism got going. People who ran away from feudal manors, serfs who didn't want to be serfs anymore, people who might have been part of lords' families, but who had no place or felt no place in feudal society, would gravitate to areas where they could be away from the feudal manner and the rigidities of feudalism in Europe. Many of these early cities and towns called themselves communes, which has a lot to do with the idea of being in a free zone, a zone free of the obligations of serfs to lords. And there are wonderful collections of historical documents. I want to read a couple off to you in case you're interested in pursuing it. The American Marxist economist Paul Sweezy and the great British Marxist economist Maurice Dobb, D-O-B-B, had a great debate back in the 50s and 60s about the transition from feudalism to capitalism, very rich with insights that have been developed by authors since. There was a journal at that time in Great Britain called Past and Present, which carried on a long debate over the transition from feudalism to capitalism, full of exactly the kinds of information that Andre Katz asked. And most recently, there's a book I would recommend called The Origins of Capitalism, appropriately enough, written by Ellen Myskins Wood, W-O-O-D, The Origins of Capitalism. These books and many that you'll find referred to in them will give you an idea of the rich complicated, long-lasting series of experiments before the people who built capitalism got it right. Very similar to the learnings of what to do and not to do from what happened in the Soviet Union or China or Cuba will inform, are already informing the next layer of efforts. That's the way transitions have gone and likely will continue to go. If these kinds of conversations, if this kind of information, if this kind of history in this case, are something you believe should be part of an intelligent conversation about where we are in the world today and where we need to go next, then we ask you to partner with us, share these videos with friends, coworkers, family. That extends our reach. That's what we need your help to do and what you are in a position to do. So partner with us. It will make us more effective and give you a chance to make the kind of contribution you want to also. And as always, if you can also help us financially, we will, of course, be grateful for anything you can send our way, and our website will tell you how to do that. Thank you for your attention. This is Richard Wolff for Democracy at Work.